Today we're going to talk about how to install on the BigTree Tech SKR version 3, the BigTree Tech TFT 70 version 3. So there's a couple of things I need to point out on the board so that you understand. First, we have our EXP1 and our EXP2. Over here, we have our TFT connection. So on the back of the touchscreen, which can also function as a legacy Marlin RepRap discount full graphics smart controller, we have other settings. So we can use this to actually toggle between, which I'll show you in a moment. But if we flip this over, I can point out all the connections. So we're gonna have an EXP 1 and 2 in here. There's also a third one. Then we have what's known as our RS-232 port over here. This will allow us to actually connect to our TFT. So the first thing that we're gonna have to do this is actually connect the cable. So I'm gonna bring the cable out here and show you it's got two different pieces. This piece is actually the reset for the reset pin, and then this is gonna go to your display. So to connect this, all you're gonna have to do is this to put it in place for your TFT. Now note you have EXP 1 and 2. So first for the EXP on this board, we're going to connect our notched connection over here. And then on the connection on the board, we'll do the same. So it's going to be right here. And then we'll do EXP2. So we'll slide this in like we did for the other one. And then we'll connect this over here. So as you can see, those are now connected. The other one I'll show you in just a second. I just want to flip this over. And we'll connect this. But we need to know where the reset button is for this particular one. So what we're going to do is we're going to go over to the desktop and we're going to look up what that is. So we're going to go to repositories on the BigTree Tech GitHub page. We're going to type SKR and this will bring up our board type. And then in here, there's a folder for the SKR for the hardware, then pins. And down in here for the pins, you can see the TFT port. And as you can see, the reset is on the top. So we're gonna go back over to the workbench. I'm going to take this and I'm going to first connect the four pins. Then I'm gonna connect the reset pin right over here and make sure that's in nice and well. Now I'm going to do some stuff with the 5 volts pin right over here so we can communicate via USB. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to connect this, but I'll show you first that it will not power without that jumper. Normally you'll use direct power from your PSU, but for now we're going to do it this way. And you want to remove this when using TMC type steppers. So we're going to power it up just to see if it works. And it appears to be working, which is good. So I'm going to power this down for a second. I'm going to actually load the firmware via this formatted FAT32 USB. So I'm going to plug that in and plug it into the computer. You may hear a beep. Now we're going to go over to the actual desktop and see how to do this. So I'm going to bring up VS Code and I'm going to open up the firmware that I downloaded, which is now 2.1. So as you can see, there's a 2.1 folder. I'll open that in the second one, then select folder. That's available on the Marlin website for downloads. So first thing that we see here is the default environment says Omega 2560. That is not our default environment. And if you've watched my previous videos in the playlist in the description, you'll know how to find out what your MCU is. But in this case, I'll tell you. It's actually the STM32H7. Pardon me for that. So what we're going to have to do is first find out our board. So we'll go to Marlin, then source, then core, then boards.h. Inside boards.h, we'll hit Control F and search on SKR underscore V3. That'll bring us to our board type. So we'll right click on that and we'll actually copy what we've highlighted for the board type. Then we'll minimize core and source, go to configuration.h, we'll search on motherboard, and down here for motherboard, we'll highlight the ramps, we'll paste over our configuration, and for the board, I'm gonna do -1 so that we communicate via USB, and then down here for the second serial, I'm going to hit Control/ to remove the comment and change this to 1. And the reason I'm doing it backwards is that I think it's logical to select the board up here and then the actual serial port for the display down here, but you can do it either way. Also, I'm going to leave the speed the same for both, so you can specify a different speed down here, which would be 250,000 bits per second. So I'll show you what happens when you change it. So you can change it to 115/200 for the speed and then enable it. And that'll allow you to actually modify it on the actual display. And I'll show you that in a few moments. But first I want to modify the Marlin folder so that we can do the RepRap discount full graphics smart controller. So I'm going to search on RepRap underscore discount, and we have the smart controller here, but it's the full graphics smart controller. So we're going to go to the next one and we're going to do the Control/ to enable. Next thing we want to do is actually search on SD card. So actually it's SD support, pardon me. And what we want to do for SD support is actually enable that for our SD card. Now there's going to be two places that it's actually enabled at the moment, but it's going to point to your actual motherboard for the SKR version 3. So to point it to the correct place, you're going to go to your advanced configuration. You're going to search on SD card underscore connection. And hopefully we'll bring this up. So let me see what I did here. I misspelled SD card. So let me see if I can find that right here, which we did. So in order to enable this, we'll do Control/, and that will bring up our actual choices that we can work with. So you can see right here that it's the LCD that it's going to point to. But you could also point it to the board by changing this value. So that'll solve one of our problems so that we don't have to worry about being able to connect to it. Now, there are other issues that may occur, but you can find those on the GitHub webpage. So if you click over here and you go back, you can see that there's issues. Now, there are currently no issues that are known, but there may be ones in the future, so you can check those. But you can also go over here and click on the actual touchscreen display, and there's issues that are outstanding that you can find if something occurs and possible ways to fix it. So you can see there are bugs right here. So let's go back over here and set up the build. So in order to do that, we have to go to the platformio.ini, and we need to change the default environment for our chipset. So in order to do that, we're going to go over to the INI. We're going to find our chipset, which is STM32H7.ini. We'll find our board type down here for the environment, so we'll copy that. Then we'll minimize the INI folder, close out of the INI, go to Platform.io, highlight the Mega2560, and paste it right here. Now, there's a couple of things I didn't cover about the actual display that I just want to show you real quick, but I'm going to actually click compile in just a second. So I'll click on the actual build button right here, but I'll do a clean first just in case. So let's click on the build, and that will build in the .pio folder over in here, and this will eventually populate our build. So while that's going on, I want to show you that there's different actual character sets you can use, and then there's also different languages you can use. Currently it's defaulted to English, but you can use the two letters. Then there's other settings that you can use in here to adjust your display by enabling them. I'm not going to show you that at the moment. There are also other menus that you can enable for your display in the legacy mode, as well as in the mode for the touchscreen display. But I'll cover that in another tutorial where I do the firmware update on the 7-inch display. So this is almost done. You can see that firmware is going to appear any second. But if you do experience an error, you can always hit the build button a second time. And if anything in red comes up, then you know that it's actually an error that you need to fix. And always fix the first one, because the others are cascade issues possibly. So let's click on firmware. We'll right click and we'll say reveal in File Explorer. Inside File Explorer, what we're going to do is copy it over to our drive, which was formatted as FAT32. And currently you can see that I had a previous load that was successful that says firmware.cur in all capital letters. So I'm going to copy this over by saying send to and send it to that drive. If it's successful in loading, it'll rename it to firmware.cur in all capital letters. So let's go back over to the desktop for a second. We're going to pop out the drive. We're then going to place the drive inside the board right here to load the firmware. And it's best to leave this in just so it doesn't give you an accidental beep message. And then we'll connect right here. So in a second, this should come up. Now it's in the legacy mode where it says no printer attached. Now when I was talking about the actual power that was an issue, you go to menu. Then what you're going to go to is settings. Then you're going to go to connection and then ports. Now this might be different depending upon your board type. So currently we're set to 250,000 bits a second. So we'll change that to 115/200. And then we'll exit out of here. And hopefully this will allow us to attach, which it did. So we're all set for that. So there are other functionality that you can explore on this. I don't want to make this tutorial too long, but I'll show you how to switch to legacy mode. If you hold this button down with your finger on the edge of the screen here, you can then turn it and select the one you want and click. Now you're in the default Marlin mode for RepRap, Discount Full Graphics Smart Controller. So at this moment, I want to thank my patrons and the people on PayPal for helping me offset the cost to make these tutorials. I'll put a link in the description if you want to join Patreon or donate via PayPal. And I'll also place a thank you at the very end of the video. So everyone, take care, be safe, remember to like and subscribe, and I'll catch you up in the next video.